All right, the big deal is the injuries. Boss will not practice. Hillis will not practice. And Dorsey hurt his calf yesterday, so he's not going to practice today. Limited will be Bo, Breston, Kendrick Lewis, Lilja, McCluster, Toribio, Wally. Those guys are going to be limited. We'll see what they can do and how they are coming along. And what they're able to do today will impact Sunday. Jake O'Connell is doing good. He's been practice full yesterday, and so looks like he's made good progress with his injury. But with that, now we're going to get ready to go. So that's what we got.
Well, certainly, Boss won't play Sunday.
Probably not.
And then Hillis?
It's doubtful.
What about Dorsey now? Where does this leave him, the fact he can't practice today?
Well, we'll have to see what he can do and how he is impacted. And with Dorsey, because he's a veteran, we'll give him every opportunity to be able to go to the game. And so we'll treat him, and then we can go up to Sunday morning to make a determination on him.
But do you feel like he's had enough practice already this week where he could?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
How long term do you think this thing with Boss is? Is this now?
Well, there's no way for me to tell, because until the doctors release him, then, you know, he can't even do anything with us. So they haven't released him yet.
Has he been sent anywhere? Like,
I mean, he.
Any of these places that deal with these things?
No, you know, we have good medical personnel here, and they're doing a good job of staying on top of it. So he hasn't been sent anywhere that I know of.
Dexter had that brace and elbow all bandaged up yesterday. How did he handle it?
He did much better than I expected him to do. And we're going to try to get a better fitting brace, a little bit smaller, yeah.
When you look at the matchups Sunday. Yeah, Lilja was a nice story, you know, playing center the other day and doing so well. And Jeff Allen, they were in there. Look at those. Chargers front's a little different than than New Orleans, isn't it? I mean, the big monsters they have. How do you counteract that?
We just have to stay lower, because leverage kind of wins at the line of scrimmage. We got to be more tenacious, and our guys have a good attitude about themselves and about the running game and about what they can do. I mean, matchups. Lilja, he's been in this league a little while, and he's had some tough matchups before, you know.
You had Casey Wickman in yesterday for a visit. Is that just to say hello, how are you, or was that to find out if he was ready to play?
Yesterday?
Or Wednesday, it was one of the 2 days.
He came by to say hi. He wanted to check on me. He heard that I was down in the dumps, and he wanted to lift my spirits a little bit, you know, so he came by to say hi. Hey, you know, with our situation, we got to investigate everything, and so we did talk to him about how he was doing. He talked to us about how we were doing, and that's where we left it.
Does Lilja really limit you anywhere? I mean, it seems like long snapping, he's doing fine, the short snaps, the deep. Limit what you do offensively at all when he's starting?
No, I think he showed last game that really there's no limit, you know, because what there was like 50 snaps that he played at center, and he handled himself very well, and so I think that after that performance, you feel pretty good about whatever you want to call with him snapping the ball.
They have. Four guys on their roster who were here in this locker room last year. Three of them on offense, and it's a whole new offense. But is there anything DeMario Williams can tell them about your defense that would help them?
Well, yeah, DeMario knows the defense. He knows how we try to play and basically what techniques we're going to use. He probably knows the adjustments that we're going to make, so he can tell them all those things. Then it's just a matter of, you know, the matchups, as you say, and who can do it better.
over all the years you've been coaching, when you get a guy who comes in from like a division rival or somebody, have you ever been able to really mine any information out of them as they come in?
Well, it just depends. So some guys are cautious. You know, when they come in and you start asking them a lot of questions, they begin to wonder, why am I really here, you know? So they're a little cautious. But every once in a while, a guy might give you a tidbit of information. But still, the information that you get is generic, and you still have to line up and play, you know? So let's say they know what adjustments we make. And if they can work that into a matchup issue for us, then that can be good for them. But if that adjustment that they know about and then we make, if our guy matches up better, then it really doesn't help them, you know. So I think that's the main things about the matchups.
Okay.